and welcome then to the MotoGP Fantasy Live, the very first one of the 2024 season, and that means it is finally time to go racing. We're gearing up for the Qatar Grand Prix, the first of 21 Grand Prix coming your way this year in 2024 MotoGP World Championship. And it's going to be a belter of a year. We've got big shots everywhere throughout all of the classes. It's going to be an exciting one to start. But here for the MotoGP Fantasy Preview Live, we're more interested in exactly how you are going to do as team managers. And that is something that we're going to start today with Tony Arbolino, who's our first guest on the MotoGP Fantasy Preview, one of the nicest guys in the paddock and also one of the Moto2 title favourites this year in 2024. So let's bring Tony in now then and say a warm hello to him. Tony, great to see you. How excited are you to get going ahead of Qatar?
Be the first one that also make me happy, you know. So yeah, just excited. The test and the winter went well, so yeah, we are ready to rock, you know.
I was gonna ask you about that winter test, because it looked like you're pretty quick, but also there's some of your competition that also looks very quick too. So you know, how hard is it going to be this year in Moto2?
Yeah, as every year, man, a lot of level as every year. So the good thing, you need to be always, let's say, try to be better. That's what I did this winter and last year. So yeah, trying to be better, trying to make my team perfection, you know, just to feel the perfection on the bike and on myself. That's what I did and that's what I was trying to do. And that's it. As every year, a lot of contenders that are really fast, let's say. Yeah, believe in me and that we can make a good job, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Of course, you had a really good year last year. Some difficulties towards the end of the year, but you definitely rebounded and found that form again towards the end of last year. So let's hope we can carry on at the start of 24 in that same way. Now, Tony, you do have a job for us to do. And as you already know, it's going to be a bit of a difficult job. So let's bring in the fantasy page that we can see. By the way, anyone watching at home, sign up
first
for fantasy.
All,
go on, Tony.
That's more difficult than win the race, sure, 100%.
Absolutely, it is. It's far more difficult. Anyone at home watching along, if you're watching on YouTube or Twitch, comment in the chat if you have any questions for Tony, by the way. We'll hopefully be able to get some questions to him. And also, looking at this blank sheet that we have in front of us for our MotoGP Fantasy team, let us know who you would put your team as, your four riders, your constructor, and also your team going in. So, Tony. The first thing that comes to is the riders. We have four riders to choose, and who stands out as your possible picks for your four riders?
Yeah, I have money. I have like...
Yes, so you have 15 million, the same as last year, okay? You'll see down here, the prices are just next to their names there on the left. Are we warning you, okay, if you go for Pecco and Jorge and maybe another one of the top riders, it leaves you quite difficult with your money situation to be able to have some good riders afterwards and the teams as well that you want.
Yeah, I think so. I'm going to put Jorge Martin
as gold. Jorge in. Okay, so he's gone into gold. So your second gold rider, who do you think?
Then...
there's some good options further down as well.
Aleix was so fast, mate. Honestly.
Yeah, he was.
In the test, I think Aleix, yeah. And then
two
Fabio.
Silver riders. Fabio
Silver.
Six. Of course, your good friend as well. Hoping to do a bit better this year with the Yamaha. Fingers crossed. It looks like it's a little bit better. Have you spoke to Fabio how it was during testing?
Yeah, he's quite happy. He's quite motivated. He's always motivated. The guy, the people know him, but yeah, I think he's able to after mid-year to make a really nice job, I think.
So now let's have a quick look, because our remaining salary is only 6.6 million and we've got three more things to put in, so we're running out fast. So your last rider, preferably we need one that is quite a steal in terms of money.
No, is Di Gian Antonio or not cheap?
He's cheap, but he's compared to some of the really cheaper ones, he's not that cheap. I mean,
So
I imagine a lot of people are going to go Pedro Acosta.
Pedro
at 1.8 is very, very cheap. So 4.8 million remaining. Now we're on to constructors and teams. Do you want to do constructors first?
Yeah, I do want.
So, Ducati are expensive because eight bikes, you know.
Aprilia.
Okay, not bad. We've seen them go pretty well. So, what does that leave us with? Actually, leaves us with a nice little number, 2.4 million for your team. But I think that should get you pretty decent team.
You have just 2.4 for the team.
Just 2.4, but that would get you the factory KTM squad, the factory Aprilia squad, the factory Yamaha squad. Aprilia. You're going heavy on Aprilia.
Yeah.
Okay, I like it.
Yeah, go heavy.
Just looking at who else we might be able to get. There's Honda. We just miss out on Gracinha Racing, which would obviously be one that a lot of people are going to go for this year with Marc Marquez there, alongside his brother Alex. So
that's crazy. I think I make a good job. Yeah,
that's a pretty good job in a very quick time, Tony. That's not bad. You've only got 100k left, so you've used your salary quite well.
100k? Give me to me. I'm gonna spend it in the shop.
Right. With 100k, that's quite a big spending spree.
Yeah.
Okay, Tony. So, are you happy with this team then?
Yeah. I made a good job. I think probably. Yeah, it's always a question about money. Yeah. This is. We know life is
always.
Like this, but. But I think this is the best one. I believe in that.
Okay, cool. So I just wanted to ask you as well, Tony. Obviously, a rider. Soon you'll be looking to go into the MotoGP class. We know there was talks around you last year going into MotoGP. Not asking for any info. Don't worry. But who do you look at this year as maybe a bit of a dark horse, someone that's going to surprise people and really be right up the front? Who do you think?
You mean in MotoGP class?
In MotoGP, yeah.
I think, mate, honestly, Pedro, my contender of last year, was so fast, mate. I see him really, really driving smooth and quick from the first laps. That's why I'm gonna say him. But I don't know. I don't really mind. But but I hope Fabio, honestly, because it's really every year is more friend of mine, and now I'm living close to him. So I hope he can get the revenge that he needs, because he worked so hard. So I think he deserved that. I hope for him.
We see you
for
train
for him for Yamaha. Yeah, for Yamaha as well, that they can
absolutely
find out a bit.
We see you two train a lot together, going running over the winter and stuff. How good is that for you in your training program? Because obviously it's great to be able to have someone there to also motivate you, but at the same time, you probably don't need much extra motivation to do that
exactly.
Training anyway.
Yeah, I feel that it's not for motivation, because I'm really motivated alone, living alone, and I'm really get used to live alone and train alone and think alone. You know, just to be a lot of time alone, I feel good with myself, you know. But I think I need him. I need him sometimes to see where my level is, to compare with him, to share some words. And most of all, I feel good with him in the free time that I have when I'm leaving. That's to just talk about other things, you know, to talk about I don't know, places, things, lifestyle, you know, just different things. And that's it. But also, I think I'm a really good not inspiration, because it's not a word, but to a really good motivation, let's say, to also to be by his side, because sometimes we do things together that maybe you don't really want to do, but then if you are together, you do it. You just do it because you say, we are together. So I think we help each other. But he's such a good guy, such a good family, and such a good people around him. So I think he's really good. Yeah.
Oh, good. It's great to hear the relationship there and how it all works behind the scenes. Now, Tony, obviously, Moto2 Championship this year is looking extremely stacked. There's contenders everywhere. Obviously, you have a new team with Philip Salac that people expect to do quite well this year. And then you look at the Bosque Oscuro riders with Fermín Ardaguer as well, who's looking in great form. Who do you think is going to be the main contenders this year, aside from yourself?
Man, I see myself. I see just myself on top. I mean, I live with this inspiration from when I was kid. Every. It's not just to say, because I see myself like this from when I was kid, every year, not just this year and not just last year. I see even in the difficult moment, you know, I see always myself on top, and that's what brings me also to make good result, even when the weekends were not starting well. So that's why I see myself winning. So I hope I can give myself back this feeling, you know. But yeah, a lot of riders. Everyone is fast in this category, but depends sometimes on the mindset and then how the evolution of the year, how will be, and how riders get used with the new tires with Pirelli. But yeah, good people around me, good stuff behind me, and yeah, more than ever. Yeah.
Now, finally, Tony, just before we let you go, because we know it's a busy day for you, the first Thursday of the season.
Yeah.
But one more fantasy thing, you can, if you want to, you can boost a rider. If you remember from last year, this was the thing where you can double one particular rider's points for that GP weekend. So would you want to boost anyone this weekend, or do you think Qatar's maybe a bit too tight to kind of say there's a clear winner?
I can boost anyone.
You can boost anyone in your team, yeah. So generally you want to boost...
In my team, that I decide.
Yes. So generally you want to boost your gold riders because they're the ones that score the 100% points. Of course, your silver riders only score half the points of your gold riders. So if you were to boost Jorge Martin or Aleix Espargaró, maybe? Or is it too close this weekend?
I'm gonna boost Martin, yeah.
Martin, okay.
Or maybe...
That was
close, bro. That was close. It's like to send a message, you know, to the guy.
Yeah.
You know, I do. Just Martin. Yeah, Martin.
Okay, cool. Let's go with Martin. Of course, had that brilliant victory in the sprint last year. And then obviously we know the issues he had on the Sunday there last year. But Tony, thank you very much for joining us. We know that you're a very busy guy today. Good luck this year. Honestly, we all think that could just be your year. So we'll see how you go. Good luck this year, Tony.
Yeah, appreciate Jack. I'm looking forward to see you soon, you know.
See you soon, Tony. Thank you.
Ciao.
So there, that is Tony Arbolino's team. And you've got to say, for how quickly he actually managed to do it, like, that's a pretty good effort. It took me a lot longer to do my fantasy team, I can tell you that. So he has gone then. He's gone Jorge Martin and he's boosted him. I didn't think he would boost someone at round one. I think round one's always just a little bit of a lottery. And you never quite know how everyone's going to hit the ground running, even though the MotoGP riders, of course, done some testing here. Then Aleix Espargaró is alongside. Not too much of a surprise to see Aleix there. 2.4 million after his championship position last year. Of course, the salaries are largely based on championship positions from last year. So that's why Aleix is perhaps a little bit cheaper than what his testing performance might say he's got. But we'll see what he's got this weekend at Qatar in round one. We know that actually last year was a bit of a disaster for Aleix in Qatar. I think he got injured after being wiped out at turn six on the race. And it wasn't a great Qatar GP for Aleix, but certainly going well there in testing. So we'll see how he goes. Not too much of a surprise to see him bring in Fabio Quartararo. Of course, there you hear just how good friends they are, training partners through the winter and also through the year as well. And Fabio, definitely some question marks over Yamaha, but if there's one rider on that Yamaha that's definitely going to whip out a performance that you might not expect, Fabio Quartararo is your man. Of course, we need to see how Alex Rins goes on his Yamaha debut, his racing debut this weekend in Qatar. And then Pedro Acosta at 1.8 million. I think everyone's going to have Pedro Acosta in their team at 1.8 million. So we'll see how the rookie Pedro goes this year. Of course, hyped up to do big things. He's got 10 races to beat Marc Marquez's record for the youngest MotoGP race winner ever. That is the GP on the Sunday, not the sprint. If he wins the sprint, it doesn't quite count in the record books and in the standings. He has to win the GP on the Sunday to pinch that record off Marc Marquez, and he's got 10 races to do that. Will he win in those first 10 races? Well, he may well do. Let's see. He's got Aprilia heavy for a constructor and a team. Certainly not a bad option at all. But generally, we see people go for Ducati as the constructor because, well, 8 bikes, it just guarantees you points every weekend. But if you're going to do that, you've got to take an extra million and go up to 3.4. So as we say then, this is Tony Arbolino's team for the first round of the year. Next time out in Portimao, we'll actually have Chaz Davies, who's returning to racing in the Moto E class. We'll see what changes he makes going into it. But it's going to be a big year for MotoGP. It's going to be an absolute cracker. Marc Marquez on a Ducati coming back. stirring up the apple cart there in terms of that. Pekka Bagnaia, through testing, has looked absolutely imperious. He's looked incredible. Will he hit the ground running? I mean, it looks like he might, but you just never, ever know in Qatar. And as you can see there, Pedro Acosta, Aleix Espargaró, there's guys like Marco Bezzecchi, Brad Binder. I mean, look at all the names here. And Andrea Bastianini's back on form in testing. Alex Marquez was looking really good on the 23, and so was Fabio Di Gianantonio, of course. Absolute miraculous year last year for Fabio Di Gianantonio to go from looking like he was out of MotoGP to winning that Grand Prix in Qatar. So certainly going to be a very good one indeed. And of course, we need to keep an eye on the Hondas as well to see how they're all going to go. It's going to be an interesting year, that is for sure. Now, if you do sign up to MotoGP Fantasy, and I suggest you do, fantasy.motogp.com, input your details, it'll bring you to a page like this, and then you'll be able to build your team. You can create your own leagues, and I'll tell you what, we'll actually create a league, shall we? Let's create a league this year. Let's call it the Moto... not the Moo. I got my microphone in the way, I can't see where I'm going. The MotoGP Fantasy League. Oh, I'll call it the Fantasy Preview League. How about that? 2024. Let's do that. Run it all year. Bosh. We'll create that. So there is the code. YP6CPRX5. Take a screenshot of that and enter, and you can join this league. So let's go and see what you can play for this year, because if you don't remember, there are actually season competition prizes up for grabs, as well as some weekly competition winners as well. And wow, that's a hell of a prize for the top place this year. You get a 2023 World Champion signed replica Suomi helmet from Pekka Bagnaia. And that's not a bad one either for second place. PlayStation 5 plus the MotoGP 24 video game. I might try and get that one myself. I've been looking at a PS5, but I haven't quite got one yet. And then the season third place, a lovely little Tissot T-Race MotoGP Limited Edition watch. My flatmate and colleague, Jack Appiard's got one of them, and I can tell you, they're rather lovely as well. And don't forget that every week, there are two Grand Prix tickets to a choice of your GP up for grabs as well, if you are the top point scorer for that particular GP that week. So then that's going to do it from the MotoGP Fantasy Preview Live, the very first one of the season. It's time to go racing in MotoGP, and we can't wait. We hope you can't either. We'll see you then. Enjoy the weekend and enjoy the track action.